Christina Aguilera was one of the standout stars and leaders of the 90s teen pop movement. Alongside Britney Spears and NSYNC, she established herself as the girl next door with a slight bit of edge with her debut single, Genie in a Bottle. Genie in a Bottle was released in 1999 and became an instant success, and went on to top the charts for 5 weeks. It was the start of an iconic career. Her self-titled debut album was a monumental success, selling over 17 million copies worldwide. Christina's music took on a female empowerment theme from the beginning, and is something she would touch upon more throughout her career. A perfect example of that could be seen in some of the singles from her debut album, including her debut single Genie in a Bottle. In Genie in a Bottle, she sets the standards and requirements of the person who wants to be with her, taking control of the narratives men commonly control. Her album had many more hits such as What a Girl Wants, Come On Over Baby, and I Turn to You, all of which solidified her stardom as a teen idol. In the year 2000, she would go on to win the Best New Artist Grammy up against her long-term peer Britney Spears. Britney and Christina had a rocky relationship, where they would eventually start to exchange shady remarks in the media, but that would be further down the line. They had no real beef. Still, the press pitted them against each other. Britney Spears was the pinnacle of the teen pop genre, since she was the first to have such a considerable breakthrough. Naturally, the media pinned every blonde-haired girl that took on the same style of music as her against her. Some of the comparisons weren't far off. Some artists that appeared during that time were obvious Britney knockoffs. And although Aguilera's label might have taken inspiration from Britney at the beginning of her career when it came to marketability, Christina was far from a knockoff and was definitely her own artist. The one thing that did set Christina Aguilera apart is her remarkable and mature voice. She has such a large and soulful voice. That type of voice is rare in general, especially when it comes to teenage acts, but it was scarce within the teen pop genre, where a lot of acts were doing their best Britney Spears impression. Sugary and sweet voices were the it factor in that genre, and because of that, Christina's label had a hard time figuring out how to market her, but obviously, everything turned out just right. Christina's second album, Mi Reflejo, a Spanish language album, was a bit of an unexpected turn. Still, it proved that she had international power, and her talent could easily capture many different markets. Christina enjoyed making the record, because she felt it would help embrace her Latin roots. The album eventually earned her a Latin Grammy. She would follow this up with a moderately successful Christmas album, but her first real stepping stone in establishing a more mature image was 2001's Moulin Rouge, better known as the remake of Lady Marmalade alongside Lil' Kim, Pink, and Maya, which at this point has become a classic song and staple in thousands of pop culture. Christina's soaring and soulful range shined on this song, and the song is often regarded as one of the best collaborations of all time. 2002's Stripped was Christina Aguilera's watershed moment. At this point in time, all the stars who ran the teen pop genre were growing up and moving in a more mature direction, and Christina had one of the most noticeable transformations from child star to teen idol to full-fledged adult superstar. Keep in mind, the leaders of the teen pop movement such as Britney Spears, Christina Aguilera, and Justin Timberlake were also Mouseketeers when they were kids, so they had spotless images from the beginning of their career. Sure, some of their teen pop hits were a bit racy, but they never truly pushed the envelope and fully dove into more substantive themes until later in their careers. Stripped was the era I feel the world truly got to know who Christina Aguilera is. She wasn't the girl who sung well and looked amazing, didn't have anything to say besides frothy pop hits. She was the girl who sung well, looked amazing, and used her powerhouse voice to embrace others and tell her story. With Stripped, she wasn't in anyone's shadow, and it is her career-defining album. Who knew a pair of chaps could have so much impact? Christina began her rebirth as an artist with a dirty introduction to the world, where she set out to break away from her teen pop image and do something that she felt more connected to. Dirty was not only a dirty song, but a song where Xena fully embraced her sexuality and did so unapologetically. It was not only the lyrical content that was different, but the genre was far from the cookie cutter and often formulaic teeny bopper days, the sound that she became famous for. She traded her by the book teen pop production in for a hard-hitting hip hop and R&B track, and by no surprise, it felt like home for her. It doesn't sound unnatural or forced, and I think part of that is because her soulful voice, which is more commonly found in the genre of R&B. Of course, back then, it wasn't only the song that made a statement, but the music video. Even to this day when you watch it, it feels like an event. Something you'll never see again. It's dirty, it's nasty, it's grimy, and it's simultaneously empowering, fascinating, and admirable. Although it's largely regarded as an iconic moment now, during that time, critics were far more harsh. She was slut-shamed, called names, spoofed, and made out to be a bad girl in the media. Christina commented on the criticism she received for Dirty in 2018 in an interview with Cosmopolitan. "It's hard to hear yourself being called names. I remember being hurt by these commercials on MTV, pitting Britney as the good girl and me as the bad girl. It's like, if I'm going to be demure and innocent, that's okay. But if I'm going to just be myself, I'm trouble. I love the female body, and I think it's something to be proud of, not something that men should dictate ownership of," she says. Dirty was extremely controversial at the time, but it would be nothing now. "I hope I paved the way and helped set the ground rules that women can be any version of themselves they want to be, and proud of it." And she has. Christina has influenced other former child stars who have also shed their kid-friendly images, such as Miley Cyrus, Selena Gomez, and Demi Lovato. Everything about this era and album wasn't dirty though. In fact, in retrospect, it's all quite beautiful, and the second single, Beautiful, showcased that quite well. Beautiful is probably the most recognizable song in Aguilera's entire discography. It's anthemic, it's personal, it's sad, and empowering. The song was penned by famed songwriter and singer Linda Perry, who also helped other stars such as Pink dive into more personal content. Perry urged Christina to face her emotions head on and translate it into music. During the recording of Stripped, Christina was in a very dark place and depressed, so she really did connect with every emotional song on the record. Beautiful was a massive hit all around the globe, and eventually earned her another Grammy Award. It's been covered numerous times and still to this date is amongst her most powerful work. Stripped, the album, was released in late 2002 and was a commercial success, selling over 4 million copies in the States alone. The critical success for Stripped didn't come until later. The initial reviews were a bit mixed and mostly focused on her transition from teen pop star to bona fide adult super pop artist. The album is not perfect. In fact, it's far from it. It runs too long, it lacks focus and cohesion, but the imperfections of this album is what truly makes it great. A teen pop star that had quite the perfect makeup, supplying the world with something so raw, intense, and unapologetic. It's a mixed bag. Whether she had a lot to say or was just making the music that she felt like, or both, it doesn't take away from it being a stripped and introspective record. Whether it's her embracing her femininity, female power, and being critical of double standards alongside Lil' Kim on Can't Hold Us Down, or trusting herself on the self-empowerment ballad, The Voice Within, she fought against what was expected of her and proved to be one of pop's top fighters. She could get through anything that was thrown at her, which is what one of the standout songs on the record, Fighter, centers around. Fighter has a universal message and can be applied to many different things, but for Christina, it was applied to her rough upbringing, her dad, and I'm sure much more as she has grown. Fighter is an R&B pop rock song, and her vocals soar on this song. Her performance on the song lives up to its title quite well. The music video is simply iconic. Instead of beautiful, dirty, or stripped Xtina, it's very theatrical and avant-garde, and is probably one of her most unexpected yet memorable looks. The video tells the story of her metamorphosis as an artist and a woman. It used animals, glass, and garments as symbolism for her transformation. Throughout the album, she dives deeper in her troubled childhood with cuts like I'm Okay, and she reasserts empowerment throughout the album with songs like Soar. The album is a very versatile body of work. It incorporates elements of R&B, hip-hop, rock, and Latin music. Stripped was ahead of its time in a sense that the themes she discussed and her approach on this album is everywhere in pop music. Not to say that those themes were new, however, the people in the teen pop genre and of her generation never really got this deep with their music. Christina was definitely one of the first ones, if not the first one, to take on such deeper subjects within her music during that time. Not only that, but the way she transformed her image is something a lot of stars that came after her have taken after. Selena Gomez cited Stripped as an influence on her 2015 album Revival. Demi Lovato also cited it as an influence for her 2017 album Tell Me You Love Me. She undeniably helped knock down some doors with this album. What makes Stripped one of her best and most revered albums is that it wasn't only about creating a controversial image. It was the first album where Christina had creative control, and she took control over the narratives that are always slipped onto women. while simultaneously taking control of her career. She was sexual, she was unapologetic, she was dirty, beautiful, and a fighter. But most importantly, she had something to say with this album, and she made sure the world heard her loud and clear.